Throughout much of the design and development of the Invincible class aircraft carriers, which served with the Royal Navy from 1980 to 2014, they weren't called aircraft carriers at all. They were actually called through-deck cruisers. This was because in the mid-60s, the British government made the interesting decision to phase out aircraft carriers completely and just have a series of helicopter carriers instead. So the Invincible class was supposed to be a development of the Tiger class cruisers, which were serving with the Navy at the time, which had been modified to have a hangar on the back, which carried four either Wessex or Sea King helicopters. So they were called through-deck cruisers, so they were going to be ships of roughly cruiser size. They ended up being a bit bigger than cruisers typically are, over double the weight of the size of cruiser that was specified in the Washington Naval Treaty as acceptable. But they were supposed to technically be cruisers, and so they were called through-deck because they had a deck that went all along the length of the hull and a small ramp at the front. Initially, it was just a seven-degree ramp, which isn't very big, on HMS Invincible and HMS Illustrious, because they also had a Sea Dart missile system there, which could be used against air threats or even ships. And since it was mounted at the bow, they didn't want the ramp to be too high and interfere with the Sea Dart. But Ark Royal, which was the third ship of the class, was built with a 12-degree ramp and Sea Dart, and the other two were modified not long after to have a 12-degree ramp. So that is just a brief overview of the design of an Invincible class aircraft carrier.